Hey guys, I'm Nisha Homi. Today I'm sharing crispy onion pakoda recipe, a quick snack which can be enjoyed by the whole family. So let's get started with the recipe. To make onion pakoda, I'm using two medium-sized onion and I'm peeling the onion. Once the onions are peeled, I'm slicing the onions thinly into a bowl. Next, I'm slicing in one green chili. Green chili you can increase or decrease as per your taste. I'm finely chopping in 1/4 of a ginger, 1 sprig of fresh curry leaves. Gather the curry leaves together and then finely chop the curry leaves. Curry leaves are a good source of iron and folate, and they also give an amazing flavor to the onion pakoda. Next, I'm chopping in a handful of coriander leaves, 1 teaspoon Kashmiri chili powder, 1/4 teaspoon turmeric powder. Today I'm using Vigon turmeric, which has high curcumin content, a fat pinch of black pepper powder, 1 teaspoon pink Himalayan salt or as needed, 1/2 teaspoon ajwain. I'm just crushing the ajwain with my hand like this and then adding in so that the flavors are released. 1 teaspoon organic coriander seeds. I'm adding the coriander seeds onto my palm and I'm crushing it with my hand like this. This will help to release the flavor and also lightly crush the coriander seeds. And with my hand, I'm mixing all this really well. So basically what I'm doing is I'm massaging the onions into the ingredients so that the moisture in the onions are released. And as you can see, now itself moisture has started to release out. And I'm going to allow this to rest for about 5 to 7 minutes. I'm covering it with a lid and letting it rest. It's about 5 minutes now, and let's check on the onion. Okay, now the onions are ready. The moisture has released out. If you take a small portion of the onions and squeeze it tightly, you can see moisture releasing out. Into this, I'm adding in 1/2 cup basin flour, also known as chickpea flour and kadala mava in Malayalam. 1/4 teaspoon hing, also known as kayam. A big fat pinch of garam masala. This will help to give that street style onion pakoda flavor. 1 1/2 tablespoon rice flour. I'm using rice flour made from hand pound raw rice. And with my hand, I'm mixing this really well. Since the moisture has released from the onions, it's easy to blend all the ingredients into the onions. You can see that the basin and rice flour easily blended into the onion mix. Now to loosen this slightly, I'm adding in a couple of tablespoons of water. So I added 2 tablespoons of water, and with my hand I'm lightly mixing this. The addition of extra water will depend upon the type of onions you are using. So if your onions does not release as much moisture as mine did, you may need to add little extra water. I'm again adding in another tablespoon of water. I added a total of 3 tablespoons of water to get the desired consistency. This is how the batter should be. It should neither be too thick nor too thin, but of spreadable consistency. And now let's fry the crispy onion pakodas. I'm heating my cast iron kadai with wood pressed coconut oil. Instead of wood pressed coconut oil, you can use any locally sourced wood pressed oil of your choice. And once the oil is heated, take small portions of the onion mix and add it into the hot oil. Now reduce the flame to medium. Remember that cast iron has more heat retention. Deep frying in healthy wood pressed oils like desi ghee, groundnut oil or coconut oil reduces the glycemic index of the food item and also helps to absorb fat soluble vitamins like vitamin A, K, E and D. Not only are the blood sugars regulated, the immune system gets built in the changing seasons and bones get a strengthening dose for the upcoming winter. So while deep frying, always choose iron-based cookware as the food doesn't absorb a whole lot of oil. So always try to make sure that you use a good quality wood-pressed oils or desi ghee in your cooking for your better health. A couple of minutes later, carefully flip it over and fry it until both sides are golden brown and is crisp. And once nicely fried and is crisp and golden, remove to a plate. Repeat the same thing with the rest of the batter. Make sure you take small portions of the onion mix. Once the last batch is fried, into the hot oil, I'm adding in a couple of sprigs of fresh curry leaves. And once the leaves are fried and is crisp, remove it and sprinkle it over the onion pakodi. And my crispy onion pakoda is ready to serve. So guys, do try this crispy onion pakoda and let me know how it turned out. Thank you for watching, and until next time, take care. Bye-bye.